I love it. All right.
So it did all right.
We gotta do
something. You haven't had your massive hit yet.
Not yet.
But yeah, so basically, the story goes you're trying to unravel why your king is being fucky and why there's all this weird stuff going down.
Damn it.
Why is your kingdom continuing to attack neutral countries? That's basically the story. And then it gets more complex from there.
Okay.
But it's really cool because it has a fuck ton of characters and they're all really interesting. Including one of my favorite characters of all time, Kane Highwind, who's also just a sexy motherfucker.
All right.
Fun fact, it was also the first time a wedding was ever shown in video games. Random fact.
Interesting.
Yes. Final Fantasy VI was the first time an opera was ever shown in video games.
Can you...
Oh, the opera.
Can you name another game that has a wedding in it? I can name two. That's it.
Give me some time. Metal Gear Solid 4 has one. That's one. Okay. What else?
Can I even name two? I can't even remember if that game...
It's fucking Mario. No, Mario never gets married. Zelda never gets married.
Let's do a game engineer.
Fucking Samus won't ever get married.
That's not new. I already made that. All right.
You got to research more stuff.
Okay.
You got to research those. You got so many options.
Yeah. Let's do that.
Dick in my ass. I'm trying to think. There's got to be games where weddings happen.
Can I give you one?
Sure.
Octodad.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah.
So that's a good one.
Yeah.
Okay. Rate, comment, and subscribe. No. Just out of curiosity, though, if you guys...
Name some off!
If you can think of some, though, please. No,
I'm actually interested. If you're still with us, I'm actually interested.
Well, this would be a new part. They would have clicked on by accident.
I'm pretty sure... I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure Sly Cooper, one of those games, has a wedding in it.
Fair
yes.
Enough.
Yes, there's a mention of a wedding.
A mention.
Well, they show it.
I got you.
So, yeah, there was a wedding in there. All right. Game research.
Damn it. Valkyria Chronicles, the marriage happens in between games. Fuck.
All right, let's do... What about engine here? Tutorials. I don't know.
Fucking sake. I guess you're right. Marriages don't often happen.
They really don't.
Well, fun fact. One happens in Final Fantasy IV.
Oh, yes?
Yes.
Wild West. Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Some people might be like, that's a spoiler. I'm like, it's not really.
I hope not.
I mean, well, the two characters are dating from the very beginning of the game, so it's not really that fucking surprising.
Let's see. Wild West. I probably want to go with action here. And let's do the gameling. Ooh.
That's 50,000.
How much does this one cost?
50,000.
No, how do I want to go about this?
I don't know.
See, I gotta go with the more stable system, though.
I didn't even pay attention. Make sure to name this game. Okay,
I will,
so it's a Wild West game.
I gotta pick the engine. I'll choose this just because, but I don't think we need a save system or anything like that. Alright. Wild West. Gunslinger. No, I'm sorry.
Gun. I remember that game. It's
Gun.
Terrible.
Yeah. How about... Oh, God, that's terrible.
What?
Well, I was thinking, you know, what has to do with a gun? I was thinking reload or cock.
Cock.
You cock the gun.
Name it gun cocker.
No. Let's do... How do you spell roulette?
R-O-U-L-E-T-T-E, I believe.
I think you're right.
I think I'm fucking right for a change. Holy shit.
Well, if not, it'll be a secret. It'll be a secret.
It'll be a secret to everyone.
A secret to everyone.
I'm so proud of myself that I spelled roulette correctly. I've never spelled a word correctly in my life.
I'm not going to lie. I think I was going to leave the U out, and that's kind of important. All right. Wild West action.
Unless it's R-O-U-L-L-E-T-E.
Well, it's a play on the word roulette. I don't know.
Just give me a second, guys.
Please, just
go about your business.
I have an iPhone. I could just...
Shut up.
Why didn't we just look it up?
No, I spelled it right.
Oh, good.
I think.
Okay. Let's do this. Scratching the head. Yes. Typing with one hand.
Siri, how do you spell roulette? Ha! Spelled it right.
You did.
The answer is roulette. Thank you, Siri. This episode is not sponsored by Siri.
It's not at all.
I just happened to have a new iPhone. I actually put the video of me destroying my old phone on this channel.
Yeah, I saw that. It was very interesting.
I was angry.
Did you take the video on your iPhone?
Yes, I did. I wanted the iPhone to know what would befall it if it tried to hurt me.
Interesting.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
World design's not so important here. Graphics and sound are.
Okay.
Because it's a Wild West action game.
Okay.
Stop it. Okay. Stop it. Oh God, please be successful.
I have...
There's a lot of bugs in this one.
Abject faith.
Abject faith.
Abject.
Fix the bugs.
Fixin'. Hardware manufacturers around the world were surprised today as Govador, the creator of the popular G64, has filed for bankruptcy.
Suckers.
Dun, dun, dun. Govador failed to introduce a higher price alternative and was forced to shut down production of the G64. The platform will retire from the market early next year.
Interesting. Fix them bugs. Dang, look at that design. Nice. This is going to be a pretty game.
Pretty.
I kept the damn save feature. I didn't even check those off.
Oh, it's fine.
But I spent extra money for no point.
This was an extra 5,000. It's not that bad. So the G64 is no longer supported.
Interesting.
People can't play your games anymore. All
right, let's finish.
Well, those three at least.
Oh, people don't throw it out as soon as it goes off the market.
Well, no, but they can't fucking get new people.
God, I still wish I had my Nintendo 64. I want to keep all my old consoles.
Well, get a retro player. That's what I have.
I know, I keep seeing those everywhere, but I already have a Super Nintendo, so I want to find one that has some consoles that I don't already own.
Fair enough.
Let's see.
I'm going to get a PS2 and a GameCube when I'm out in California.
I still have my PlayStation 2.
Well,
I have mine,
but I'm going to leave it with my brother. I'm taking my Xbox 360, but I'm going to get my own PS2. And we have a PS3 already. Brianna has one.
Nice.
Yep.
Don't you have a PS4, too? Oh, no, the PS4 stays here.
PS4 staying with Byron.
Okay.
Oh, they're kind of split on this one.
Interesting.
Wow.
Oof.
What does this fellow think?
You're killing me.
Stargames thought you were great.
The level design saved this game. Mm. Oh. You're killing me, Smalls. God, all right.
Come on, Littlefinger. What's up? I've been, Okay, so I've been reading Game of Thrones.
Oh, I love those books.
Tiny spoiler, guys.
No,
I'll try to
no,
be good.
Don't.
No, this is from the first book.
If you haven't seen the first season yet, good lord, people.
This
go
is just
ahead.
A tiny thing. Why is it that of all of the miserable fucking evil people in that world, why is it you get the king of barbarians, this leader of these hordes of men? He turns out to be a nice dude.
Yeah, I know.
Why is Drogo so cool?
He's a lot nicer in the books than he is in the
oh,
show.
Oh, yeah.
In the show, he's just like, nah, I'm going to rape her on her. Yeah, no, they had amazing, like, romantic sex in the book.
He's so awesome.
Yeah, he's like a nice dude, and they made him out to be, like ridiculous.
Yeah, that pisses me off. In the book, like, he tries to learn her language just so he can speak to her better.
Yep.
And... like, do you remember what he fucking says to her when they're about to consummate his marriage? He's like, I understand the word no.
Yeah.
It's like, holy shit, he's awesome.
Yep.
And then, like...
In this show, it's almost like she was forced to learn their language. He never tries.
No, she actively tries to learn their language because she actually likes him. When... Okay, here's the spoiler part. Cover your ears for... Oh, wait, how far are you?
What do you mean?
How far are you in the
in
books?
In the books? At the end of the third book.
Okay.
Clash of Kings.
So how are the dragon eggs doing?
Oh, they've already...
Okay, good.
What are you talking about?
I can't fucking
remember.
They
hatch at the end of the first book.
Oh, okay, you're right. I fucking get confused.
What are you talking about?
Spoilers, guys, for 5 seconds. In the fucking book, when he dies, she names one of them after him. Mm-hmm. She names one of them...
No, she names one of them after her son that would have been born.
Well, no, but she calls him It's like some variation of Drogo. It's like Drogovan or Drogovish. Drogo something.
It's... Yeah, but it's...
The point is she's... It's partially
she
honor
one of them Drogo,
him.
One of them Rhaegar, which would have been her son, and the other one is Drac.
The point is he is an awesome character and they had an awesome relationship.
Yeah.
So it sucks dick that he died.
Mm-hmm.
And it also sucks dick that I just feel like he didn't get represented as well as he should have in the show.
I've got a lot of money, but I'm not actually... I gotta wait for the next generation of games.
Makes sense. Also,
I don't think I want to do contrast.
Daenerys Targaryen is also awesome. So that's a given.
She really is. It's kind of funny because in the show,
her boobies are outstanding. Continue.
In the show, it's just like Daenerys Stormborn, you know, the last Targaryen. In the book, Dany.
Yeah.
It's just Dany.
Okay, I was having this conversation with someone. Why does she want to go back and take the throne?
She
has a kingdom that fucking loves her and worships her as though she was a god.
It's amazing because at the end of, what was it? At the end of the second
spoilers.
Book. Yeah, spoilers.
Sorry, guys. Spoilers. We're having a conversation here.
At the end of the second book, when she gets the Unsullied and all that. I'm trying here. When she gets the Unsullied, she finally realizes that she doesn't want to be a ruler anymore. She wants to be a savior. She wants to go around and save everybody, and she knows she'd be a better ruler. And I still think she would. I get that,
and I'm almost certain. My theory is that unless Martin pulls a trick on us, I think that she's going to have the throne at the end because she's the only person who wouldn't go insane having the throne.
I suppose.
Maybe Tyrion, but I think even Tyrion would lose his shit if he had it.
Tyrion doesn't want to be king.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, I don't think Tyrion would be fit to be the king, so I think she's the only person who can have that throne and not go insane.
Yeah.
Like who else could have that throne and not be a complete lunatic or be a dick?
If they had given Stannis his rightful claim to the throne before he met the Red Lady, I think he would have been a fine ruler.
Sure, but it's
he wouldn't have gone insane. It is very too late for that man. All right,
this
is the wrong choice.
If it's gonna have a happy ending, it has to be Daenerys.
Let's see what other topics I can get, actually.
But then again, Martin does not care about its happy endings.
The problem with that is I don't think it's gonna have a happy ending.
I don't either. I think it's. Have I told you my theory?
Of what?
It's called A Song of Ice and Fire.
What is this?
Werewolf.
What is this topic? I don't...
Fucking Castlevania Werewolf Edition.
Oh, I could so make Castlevania.
You haven't got the vampire option yet.
I don't know. I could make a werewolf Castlevania. That would be more... I'll make a werewolf Castlevania. It would be even cooler.
With blackjack and hookers. That's the best thing to throw.
I'll design Fable and we'll just have orgies.
Fucking, that's my favorite quote from Futurama. Just whenever somebody says, I'll make my own, just throw in, with blackjack and hookers.
Let's do werewolf for now.
But, okay, so this might seem ridiculous, but so Ned's fuck-off incredible sword was called Ice.
I know.
And it's called A Song of Ice and Fire. He did not call it A Song of Ice and Fire just idly. That means something. And there's the themes of winter and summer.
Yeah.
I think that there's going to be, at some point, a sword called Fire.
Well...
That's my theory.
I've got a spoiler from the book that this is actually a big spoiler. It's not, okay, it's not huge in terms of story, but it's big because they haven't covered it in the show at all. This is just from my knowledge of the books. And when Ned is killed,
yes,
his sword gets taken by Sir Ilm.
Yeah.
Somewhere in the third book, suddenly that sword goes missing and fucking... Okay, the most badass villain in this entire book. Can you guess?
I'm thinking Littlefinger. Littlefinger's
no,
such a bitch.
No, it's Tywin.
Oh, okay.
Tywin commissions the building of two Valyrian steel swords that have a reddish tint to them.
I'm telling you, fire.
One of them is a one-handed sword and the other is a two-handed sword. And when Tyrion inspects the sword, he says... Let me guess, that's for the king. He's like, yes. And the big sword, Tyrion doesn't even have to ask. He knows it's for Jaime. And he says, not even a dagger for your son. And he looks down at Tyrion and says, there was only enough steel for two blades.
I'm telling you, fire.
But you don't, do you?
No, yes, I realize.
They melted down ice.
I'm telling
you. The fuckers melted ice.
I'm telling you, but the symbolism is going to be, you know, so it's all about winter. It's been about winter for so long, but it's going to come full circle to summer, and then there will be fire.
Ooh, wait, whoa. 17.
It is hard to play this game and talk.
It is. Well, because I have to read everything.
I know. Sorry, guys, we were having a conversation. We're done.
I don't want to buy a new license.
We won't talk about a show that you may have inexplicably not seen yet. Or a book that you inexplicably have not read.
Red.
Shut up. I'm typing.
What are you doing?
I'm telling the guys that they can come whenever they want. There. You can C-U-M whenever you want, guys.
C-U-M.
I thought they should know.
I'm successful. Look at how successful I am. Why is it not doing
there? Oh, you named it
Game Break. I already have a... You can, oh, damn it!
Don't worry, you can fix that the end I learned.
Good. All right. Let's see. Level design's important.
Yeah, it's all right.
But dialogues need to be a little bit... Because I'm basically making Castlevania here.
Indeed.
So...
Castlevania! Castlevania.
I don't know. It's saying minus, but
what's
I don't see
what's your favorite Castlevania game?
Oh, Symphony of the Night.
Correct.
Oh, what kind of question is that?
Some people like earlier ones.
Oh, well, yeah. But no, Symphony of the Night. I do like Super Castlevania.
For me, it's Symphony of the Night, then Aria of Sorrow, and then Harmony of Dissonance.
I don't think I've played Harmony of Dissonance.
It's good. Me and Will are playing through it on the channel right now. It's lovely. Well, not right now. It hasn't come out yet. Guess what, guys? We're playing Harmony of Dissonance.
Next time. So can I name it now?
Yes. When it brings up the final menu, when you hit finish, it has a little edit thing next to the name. I believe that means you have to hit finish first. Oh, right, bugs.
Well, I got a bug and then I fixed it, so.
Oh, good. So,
interesting.
And so now... Venna has announced that they will now release a new gaming console in 2 months, the Venna Oasis, with 16-bit graphics.
Do you know what that is?
And sound, which promises a new kind of gaming experiments.
Oh my god, I can't wait for the Super Nintendo. I can't wait for the Super Nintendo.
The announcement of the Oasis is...
this is like 30 years prior, and I'm sitting here, I can't wait for the Super Nintendo. Okay. Mature audiences.
Mature. Is he up there?
Mm-hmm.
I think that means you can change it.
Thank God. Okay.
Wassel.
No, I'm not taking a page from Castlevania. I'm going to try and be a little bit more clever.
Castle Wolfenstein.
No. Okay. How about... I don't know. Is there a fancy name for Stages of the Moon?
The Lunar Cycle.
It's a little too on the nose.
I don't know. That'd be kind of a cool name.
Lunar Cycle.
The Lunar Cycle. The
Lunar Cycle. I wish I could actually tweak the game because I would make your character like the Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde principle, where you'd be like a dude and you'd have like medieval weapons, but then in certain points of the game you turn into a werewolf, or maybe if you killed enough enemies you'd turn into a werewolf and then you could like jump around and you'd jump higher and you'd get faster attacks or something, or... and then you could, like, climb walls because you had claws, and that would be a different part of the game. So if you turned into a werewolf, you could go back to other parts of the game when you saw power-ups. I don't mean to toot my own horn, but I'd be good at this.
I stopped listening.
I'd be good at this. I know, you're sitting over there texting.
I'm actually listening. I'm just, you know.
Maybe I'll just name it Bullet.
Bullet?
Bullet. Like, Silver Bullet.
Keep doing what you're doing. I'm totally listening.
You're leaving.
Uh-uh.
You've lost faith.
Uh-uh.
How about...
I'm bringing my dog inside because people are coming over and I don't want him to get out.
There.
So
that's
say hello.
Catchy.
Moonlight. Okay.
Yes.
Really?
Moonlight.
So the lunar cycle was stupid.
Yes.
But moonlight isn't.
Yes, because again, different points of the game, when the moon comes out, you turn into the werewolf.
So, yeah, okay.
So it has to do with... That's a mechanic of the game. It's a mechanic.
What's the Bioshock mechanic of Bioshock?
The Bioshock mechanic of Bioshock?
Mm-hmm.
There really isn't any sort of newfangled mechanic. You shoot and you hit people with a wrench.
I am just fucking around. Okay, hit okay.
Jesus.
Hey, 3D graphics.
Yes! Surgeon Simulator, here we come.
In like the fucking 90s.
Oh, it would be so awful. Jeez. Do you know how many bugs there would be?
Ugh.
Wait, I named it Moonlight.
Oh, I'm sure it's fine.
I'm sure it's not.
Oh, whatever.
What the fuck?
Maybe you didn't hit enter.
Whatever.
Yeah, it's fine.
It's better than the name!
Oh my god.
Oh, you clever sons of bitches.
Made fun of you. Your games are so stoically average.
Hey.
I mean, that's fine. That's fine.
All right. Beautiful.
There are worse things to be.
Oh, such a good idea for a game, too. Damn.
I'm trying to think of a company that only releases average games. I suppose...
I don't know.
I got nothing.
I don't know.
Most companies at least have one really good game.
Or one really bad bomb.
True.
Alright. Alright. Here we go. Here we go. Why am I researching 3D? Do these consoles even support 3D? I can make Doom.
You are the midway of gaming. The midway home entertainment.
Hey. You know what? Their PlayStation 2 generation of games were pretty good.
I'm just saying, makers of such classics such as Spy Hunter, a game I got for 99 cents in a grab bag.
Hey, I can't even think of any midway games right off the bat.
I'm literally just looking
for... Oh, Gauntlet, Rampage, all okay. PlayStation 2 titles, fantastic.
I'm just looking through list of games and looking at my games over on my wall.
I'm gonna make Doom. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna make a Western version of Doom. No, I'm gonna stay true to it and make it sci-fi. Yes. It's going to be amazing. 3D graphics. Okay. Here we go. Wait, is Doom even 3D? That's considered 3D, right?
I guess. All right. You are so good, you are almost never soft. Creators of such wonderful classics such as Tony Hawk's Underground Number 2.
Oh god, the Tony Hawk games.
Join Tony and Bam on the sickest road trip ever.
And Bam?
Outrageous stunts. Team Hawk versus Team Bam.
This is going to be an expensive game.
World Destruction Tour.
World Destruction Tour?
I'm just...
World Destruction Tour?
Yeah.
Ugh. They could have stopped at World, but no, they went Destruction Tour. Game 8 is now off the market. Damn it, the new name didn't take. My werewolf game will forever be known.
I hope they like the game engine number 3.
Damn it!
You're so bad at that.
That should be the last thing you do! Because I haven't decided on, like, what the game engine's focused on or what the game is focused on. That should be the last thing you do.
How about Thunderstrike, Operation Phoenix? Fun, fast, furious.
Okay, can I just ask a question right now? Why do you own all these shitty games?
I had a grab bag that cost 99 cents.
You're a fool. Video game grab bags are almost never worth it. What is wrong with
you? What are you talking about? That was literally minutes of entertainment we just had there.
Is that right? Was it worth it?
No.
I didn't think so.
So what you gonna do? School!
Is it different every time or is it always school now? Every time I select
it. Yeah, it's always...
It's always gonna be school
it's
now.
It's always Derpina.
Derpina. Damn it, I don't want school.
Hi, Jack.
Screw the school.
Quit school, kids.
Drop out.
Drop out, because this game told you to. Jackal says hi, guys.
Sci-fi. Action.
Arr. I have a dog.
Vienna Oasis. Ooh, that license is pricey. Game engine, the Wave Rock. No, I need 3 because it's got...
Game Engine 3, you name it.
Yeah, I know. So instead of Doom, we're going to have Crisis. Oh, damn it. Yeah. How about...
Apocalypse. Armageddon.
Armageddon. I'm sure there's a game named Ragnarok.
Oh, wait, there's a game called Ragnarok.
Damn, all the good ones are taken.
Yeah, it's sort of like there's been a video game industry for 40 years.
Sort of. With shitty names.
What are you talking about?
They all just come up with some kind of crappy name, though, you have to admit. At least, like, some of them are vaguely relevant, like Gears of War is vaguely relevant because the cogs are the name tags, but...
Phantom Pain.
Okay, yeah, but most of them are just crap.
Final Fantasy.
Most of them are just crap.
Reign of Chaos.
Most of them are just crap.
You fucking telling me that Reign of Chaos is an awesome name?
No, I'm just saying, like, Crisis or Red Alert or... they're just movie titles revamped.
I'm picking up what you're putting down.
Battleship The Game.
I'm picking up what you're throwing down.
Superman The Game.
Keep hitting the buttons.
Anyway.
This is recorded live.
Yeah, I know.
For the interwebs.
Interwebs. How about... it's like a Doom thing.
Oh, nice. They're actually not terrible.
All my titles are pretty good.
Except for number 8 and number 1 and the Game Engine 3.
Not my fault.
Mm-hmm.
Not my fault. really, really not.
Proposition.
What the hell? It's cryptic.
This is a very special offer.
All of our audience members can read. Good
Our
Lord.
Agents have recently managed to borrow. Okay, go ahead. We'll contact you, Agent Blowfish. What will you do?
Are you fucking serious?
Do you trust him?
Of course not.
Yeah.
That's the sketchiest thing I've ever seen.
Yeah. No. Yeah. Seems Yeah. So is this game gonna have tutorials or save games?
This is gonna be all out.
Yeah, sure.
This is gonna be all out.
Alright.
It better get a higher score than fucking 5.
Fucking 5 specifically.
Oh dear God.
Fucking 5 was not our most popular game.
Okay.
No dialogue. Dialogue's for the weak. Does Doom have dialogue in the first one?
It's mostly just arr.
Well, like, I mean, is there even a story to the first Doom? I mean, other than fucking you're on a planet, there be demons, fuck them in the butt.
I'm not gonna lie, I don't remember.
I'm trying to think if there's any in-between dialogue. Like, I know there's a blurb on the manual, but I mean, I'm trying to think if there's a like any talk in the game.
I don't know.
I don't think there is.
Sound's gotta be important too, but mostly graphics.
Logical.
Very.
Yonical.
That is very logical.
Fucking quote Spock in my presence.
I love Spock.
I know, I do too.
What's wrong with Spock, sir?
Nothing. I just don't appreciate a mockery made of his.
I'm not mocking him. It's an homage.
I'm just rambling.
One of these days we'll be popular. We'll get Leonard Nimoy.
Well, you've been making games for 6 years and you are distinctly average. Although 1,700 people think you're great.
I'm trying.
I mean, you haven't failed.
I'm the kid in the garage who just makes A games, apparently.
Well, you know, for 6 years and you've made a lot of money off of it.
I had to spend a ton on this one, though. I had $500,000.
True, but that just means it's going to make.
What is this? I'm level 3?
Yeah, you're getting better. You're getting more skilled.
It's just not hitting me that this is a game about games.
Oh, it will.
Also, that's the Wii noise.
Yeah.
Okay, just point that out.
It's made by 2 people. Give it a break.
Better user experience, level editor, open world. Ooh, open world and RPG.
Yeah, this game gets super complex as it goes on.
I just meshed my fingers together so you people know.
Gross.
Well, just open world and RPG, sir.
I know, I'm mocking you.
Okay, here we go. Moment of truth.
And 8.
Ugh.
And 9. There
yeah.
you go. And 9.
Congratulations, I've created Doom.
Well, you had
almost
to make something.
Perfect. Holy shit.
Look at that. You did. That's a. What is that? That's a.
It's a 9.3? 9.5?
Something like that.
Yeah, that's pretty.
It's a number.
It's pretty amazing. We have a stranger sneaking into the room.
It's true. One of the people is going to be joining us soon has just arrived.
My company's better than yours.
Well, it's all right.
I just made Doom. And people loved it. I'm sure if I really did travel back in time and I'm creating all these games ahead of time, you gotta imagine when I made the Werewolf Castlevania thing and Doom and Contra, all the original creators were like, damn it!
Konami was just like, motherfucker.
Wait till I make Sonic the Hedgehog. Watch out, Capcom. I'm coming for you. Oh my god, I'm gonna make Resident Evil. Jesus Christ, I'm gonna break this. All right, research.
So we have the lead creator of OuBei Safei here as well.
Oh, that was you?
Joining us for the night.
It was you, OuBei Safei?
I was OuBei Safei. I am OuBei Safei.
So one of the competitors has arrived.
I'm not looking at the screen.
He's going to be joining us in a video we're doing after this.
You can look. It won't save you.
Wow.
I'm going to destroy your company.
You gained 3 fans from that incredible game.
Wait,
how long have you been
23K.
At this?
A while.
6 years?
Apparently.
6 years, yeah.
Apparently.
Damn, you are doing better.
There it is! There it is!
Oh, God.
Oh.
Well, she didn't release a 1 on her first game
I'm
like
so
you really
yeah.
did.
Yeah, you know what? I think she's gonna win already.
I don't know if that's true.
I made a 7 my first try.
She hasn't named any of her
7?
Games.
Yeah.
That being said, seven. She keeps forgetting to name her games.
I'm sorry. That should be the last thing you fill out.
Oh my god.
Simple game design. You should pick your topic first, and then everything else, and then name it. Because
wine,
I don't can't
wine,
think...
bitch, bitch.
Is that what you named your company?
You're mad because I'm right. What?
Wine, wine, bitch, bitch.
No, she's Microsucket.
I'm Microsucket.
What was the other company?
Electric one? Farts.
Electric Farts?
Yeah.
Simple.
Indie.
It's very elegant. Okay, open world.
You should all know that during all of this, Butts Galorian is wiping the floor with all of you.
Oh, okay. Is that canon now?
I mean, they've already finished. They retired.
I'm really waiting for the fantasy topic.
I'm sure you'll get it eventually.
But it's just not happening.
Fucking research more then.
But the next one is fucking school.
School. Make a school sim.
No.
School. Do it.
Fuck no.
Do it.
No.
Peer pressure.
Christ. I'm not listening.
My next game's gonna be
a school sim.
A school sim.
I don't even remember what other games you made.
What's that joke? I hope Mariko's son notices me today.
Shut up.
Oh god, I have like two anime friends. That's why
is
I
my
know
person's
that.
Name Senpai in mine?
Senpai, that was it.
I forget. No, you're Weipon something.
Weipon Pon or something.
I think you're Wei Shen.
Shin something.
Get up here, so just to make sure the mic can hear you.
Oh
longer.
No!
I'm sorry, I'm being attacked right now.
No, it's fine. Please.
No, I have 9 research. I need 10 to get a new topic. Damn it! All right. I really want to make Legend of Zelda. But
he's punishing you for earlier. Leave him alone.
Look at that.
I know, right? He'll give up eventually.
I really wanted to make.
So these are your current consoles out, right?
Wait, yeah. I thought they released the Super Nintendo, or is it just
they're
it's in development?
Oh, okay.
They became public about their plans.
I see. Okay. Much time travel's been good to me. I may do a time travel open world RPG.
You do whatever you need to do.
How about a sci-fi open world RPG?
It's a strong dog.
17.
Did you hear about how our buddy Harlow 6 got completely mutilated yesterday?
No.
He was at a LARPing event. And one of his allies came at him with a pole arm.
His ally?
One of his allies came at him with a pole arm, I guess by accident, and just straight into his balls. And Harlow 6. And he bought his cup literally that day, and he hadn't put it on yet. And just destroyed him. He was just sad for the rest of the day. He was just sitting there in
sadness.
I'm
making a surgery
simulator. You can put him out, by the way, if you want.
I like to imagine that, like,
making a surgery
earlier
sim.
That day, since he does go with someone else, like he rides there with someone else.
Yeah.
The guy must have known. Oh yeah, he bought a cup, so he must have gone on to guy over to the guy with the pole arm. He's just like, hey, my buddy over there, you want to test out his cup?
Yeah, sure. Flatline. Good job.
Surgery simulator, 3D.
Surgery simulator.
Yep.
Is that the first one you named?
What? No, I had some pretty good names actually.
She just constantly forgets.
We don't need the save game. We don't need a linear story.
You don't.
I don't need it. I need to save up my money.
You've got 5,555 enigmaners.
This is good, actually. That works. Okay, let's see. I named my Doom comparison Last Man. Damn it, you release it now?
Not as good as Heavenly Sky Machine, though.
Heavenly Sky Machine? Which one was that?
That was one of my games from when I wasn't allowed to think of the name. I said to type.
Dialogues have to be decent.
You just had this.
And so some of them were awful.
That sounds like a terrible writing prompt.
Like, yeah, it was awful. That's why my company is called Butts Galorian.
This may not be so good.
Because I typed B-U-T and then had to work with what I had.
Oh, so you couldn't use backspace at all?
No, that was the rule. I couldn't backspace and I couldn't think about what I was typing.
I may need to get some better sound.
Yeah, I mean, maybe. Considering you're fucking 6 years. You were in 1991 and all of your games are bleep, bloop, 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 bleep, bleep, bloop, bleep, bloop, bloop, bleep.
Yep.
Bleep, bloop.
I may need some better sounds.
Dude, Elmo's ABC Adventure has better sound than you right now.
Yep, I'm aware.
fucking Muppet Treasure Island the game has better sound.
Hey, because that game, that awesome. Game is awesome.
That game is fucking awesome, by the way.
I'm just trying to make enough money so I can put a game on the new console, guys.
All right. Can we just talk about how that's one of the greatest games ever made?
Can we please?
That game's so good.
Just like, you know, Circle Jerk right now.
Just like, I really like Muppet. Also an amazing movie.
That movie's amazing. What console is that for?
That's on PC. I have it. It's great.
I don't think I've ever played it.
Holy shit. You should play it before I leave.
Oh, God. All right.
That's a game meant for eight-year-olds. It'll be amazing. It's like a kid's game, but it's really well done.
I've unlocked cutscenes. Yes. Okay. My research is now.
You know a game we never got around to playing that we talked about?
What's that?
Putt-Putt's Adventure.
What's the difference between UFO and sci-fi
It's
now?
Fucking specifically about... It's like a fucking alien conquest game for the...
It's Space Invaders at the very base.
Here we go. Yeah. This is gonna be bad.
Oh,
shit!
Are you kidding me?
What we've learned today is Surgeon Sim is the greatest game ever made.
What?
I didn't like it.
Oh, what a cock. Game Hero again, of course.
They always hate it.
God.
I think you may have
got here just to see her continue on to the next level.
I can't believe this.
This is gonna make so much money.
Oh my god.
Gay ass phone off, Tony. This is a moment.
This is perfect.
Rank 4.
I've almost made it to 1 million, guys.
And there it is.
Jesus. Only took me 7 years.
Micro suck it. Alright, are you ready to move on to the next level?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Oh, does that mean I won't be able to... I won't be able to make games for the Super Nintendo?
No. It just means you get a new office.
Yes.
And can hire more employees.
Yes.
And it also means that this video is over.
Oh, okay.
However, we're going to take a look back at the games you've made over the years.
We do
at the end of every one of these.
I've had a pretty successful run, actually.
Yeah, well, it's...
Look at it! It says Microsucket.
Microsucket. Yeah.
It says Microsucket.
Isn't that lovely?
Oh, my God.
I told you, this game gets complex. Okay, so just click anywhere. And you're going to go to game history?
Yep.
And go back to the very beginning, and we'll take a look at where you've been. And Tony, you can enjoy. You can learn.
I named it game 1.
So, because she was very confident, she named her first game number 1.
Not last game?
Not last game, no. It was a time travel adventure. It did a lot better than the other starts we've seen.
Yep.
Okay.
So after that, we had... Please move. No, you gotta click on the name.
Okay.
So after that, we had...
Smiley, surprised, angry.
We had...
It was a detective adventure game.
Also, was very average. She had a theme of average.
Yeah, I had a theme of average.
Okay. We followed that up.
7.5 is technically above average.
So technically.
And then we had Monkey Madness, which was...
Not too good.
We lost a little money. A little.
Yeah, we did.
Just a tiny bit.
So Firewall.
Firewall was once again pretty.
You got some money from that. That's good.
Yeah, I did. I profited.
Moved on to Stream.
It was my decision to put it on that one.
Of course.
Stream.
Moved on to Stream, the time travel RPG Chrono Trigger.
Yep.
It was not that well received. It was all right. It was good.
Chrono Trigger only got like a 7.75 in this universe.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, you know.
It wasn't exactly... I didn't upgrade the sound or the graphics.
And she was learning. Didn't know how engines worked.
Okay, so this one.
So we made Galoran.
Okay.
Even I can tell it's Galoran.
Galen free.
Come on, Leon. All right. So yeah, that one didn't average.
Then we had the spelled totally correct roulette, which I was so proud of.
We totally guessed.
And it was eh.
This was my werewolf game that I forgot to name.
It was supposed to be named Moonlight.
It was going to be Moonlight.
Stupid
name. It was
going to
be awesome. It's a good idea. Anyway.
Yeah, you know,
then I made Last Man, which is basically Doom.
Did pretty damn well.
Pretty very well.
And this is where she had her great big hit on the Vena Oasis of all things.
Uh-huh.
She made Flatline, the Surgeon Simulator.
I just like to imagine that's like Surgeon Simulator 2013 with like the really wonky hand. Just like you have one hand out there on that controller.
How on earth could this be a good game on the Sega Genesis?
But it's like that footage like from Night Trap.
Yeah.
But for Surgeon Simulator.
It is.
It's a real surgery, but in shitty fucking Genesis graphics.
Okay, so there we go.
The thing is, though, it has a really good story.
Well, oh, yeah. So, it's talking about how your game was awesome. And we're going to save the game.
Oh my god, wait. The poster!
You're still number 8.
I am the person with the score of 8.
All right. And so, like I said...
Is that the PlayStation?
No.
Okay, good.
And we are going to exit out. Okay. Thank you guys for watching. Everybody has
Please
made it to...
Please rate, comment, and subscribe. It really helps us out.
Well, guess who just arrived? All right, see you guys. We'll talk to you later.